everyone, welcome to Liberal Rebel. This is the new Kia Rio, and I think we can all agree here, this car looks fantastic. Yes, we parked it here with the sunroof a bit up and the wheel turned, just so we can look even better. Now, if we come around to the front and we have a look at Kia's new design, they've, I think, personally found their new design language. This grille, that strangely enough, continues its pattern on the window here on top. I think that's the camera make up a bit close and I can show you. If we have a look over here, they continue the shape on the windscreen, which is so cool. And if you look at these wheels, they are 17-inch 205 45 17s tires by Continental. Now there is some functional aero going on here. If you look over here and you check this little dams here, right, if you come around the back of the bumper, you'll see that there is still a little functional part over there. I mean, look at that. If you look at the back of this Kia Rio, we will see immediately that how far this brand has come. The striking looking tail lights, that shape quite pretty. And if I open the boot up, you find a healthy dose of space. If I lift up the little tray at the bottom, you find a full size spare wheel. That's certainly not cheaping it out, considering this car starts at 233,000 Rand, so it is actually quite cheap in the segment. Oh, that was funny. I mean, at the back of the Kia Rio, we find a generous amount of legroom and even a USB port. I mean, that is so nice. The seats at the back is really comfortable. There's quite a bit of light coming in. If I put my head back, I can really relax. There's a door. What you call this thing again? I forgot again. But there's a thing here on top. And the seats can, if I pull here, fold down. Now the seat doesn't fold flat with the boot. There's quite a bit of a lip still here. But that's fine. I mean, considering the car's price and already what you're getting at that price is pretty intense. Before I show you the front, let's go for a drive. So what's this Kia like to drive? Well, interesting. It's not the quickest car in the world, but it makes more than well up for that with sprightly handling. I mean, it's really fun. And you can actually take speeds, ludicrous speeds around corners, and the car just like doesn't stress. It's not go. I think the Contis are really helping the handling a lot out of this car, but it is quite a lot of fun. Now the suspension, it's quite compliant. It does get a bit jarring over certain types of bumps, but there's nothing to complain about. Like, we're driving on smooth roads, the car's actually really well refined. It's quite quiet overall. And if you do want to drone some of the outside sounds off, you can just turn the volume up of this excellent sound system. There's got quite a nice lot of punch and bass to it, and volume to keep you satisfied. So it's powered by a 1.4 litre engine, petrol, producing 79 kilowatt and 135 newton meters of torque. It's then attached to a 6-speed automatic transmission in this version of this car. It might not sound like a lot, but trust me guys, I got astonishing fuel consumption. Up to 7.7 liters per 100 kilometers I've been seeing on this car for this week, and I've been driving this car for 7 days absolutely everywhere here in Cape Town. I was even in Paarl with the car and it kept giving me between 7.5 and 7.8 liters per 100 kilometers. That's really impressive. This specific Kia Rio is actually equipped quite well. The specific one I'm in goes for over 280,000 Rand, which still is quite a good price considering everything I'm getting here. It's off the score up, it's really hot in Cape Town, so you're gonna hear a bit of. Yeah, and that's the radio. Let me just turn that down quickly. Yeah, it does beep quite a lot. So let me quickly talk you through the infotainment system. This is Kia's infotainment system, and I'm not gonna lie, it's really easy to use. We've got big buttons over here to take us to the different menus. If I push the home button, you can connect your phone via the USB cable. You get Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. You get Bluetooth as well, very easy to use. You can go to your setup, swipe through different menus. Everything is fast and responsive. You can go back to your media again, but obviously my phone isn't connected at this point. And you can even use your maps once you connect your phone via the USB cable. If we move lower down from this point, we get to the climate control settings, and look how cool
this looks almost like the, you can keep a finger and just push almost like a missile launcher. I actually like it. It's really nice about this car. Simple to use, fan speed, temperature on the side over here, recycle, put it off your rear defroster, front defroster, everything is simple to use. What gets interesting here is what's over here. We have a USB input for your phone, we have an auxiliary input. We have a cigarette lighter, and on this side over here, a 12 volt 180 watt output. So you can like plug a small little vacuum cleaner in to vacuum your car or a fridge if you're on camping. And a nice big pocket here in the center for your keys, headphones, whatever it is when you're busy jamming. Like I said, this is the automatic version. You actually have manual controls over the gears. You can go that way and you can minus or plus to change different gears. And in the center here we have a cup holder. They give you a little smoker's jar to put your cigarette ash in. If you take it out, you get two cup holders. And in the center armrest, a small pocket to put your things in. Yeah. That's about it. The specific one has a sunroof as well. So the normal stuff, you can open this all the way up. You can close your sunroof. You have a little sunglass place over here. Obviously you have mirrors over here that is lit. Which is quite cool. So yeah man, really well spec'd out. I must say, I always thought like Kia in the past, if we look at where Kia is now, this is unbelievable. It bongs for absolutely everything. Bong. A different bong. Why? I'm really looking for stuff now, but as a personal preference, I wish it had the LED headlamps, because that would have been just, I added extra, they could have made you pay a little bit more for LED headlamps, but this is fine, but I'm really just looking for stuff now, to be honest. The first thing I like about this car is, Kia gives you a place to put your phone, and even this huge iPhone 7 can fit over there. That's cool. You get an auto dimming rear view mirror as well that Kia throws into the package, which means if someone is behind you flashing their lights or driving like an idiot with their brights on, you don't have to be worried about being blinded. And the last thing I like is the sound system. It is quite... powerful. I must say Kia has come a really long way. And to be driving in a car that feels this refined to drive, it's a big surprise to me. I remember driving in Kias of the past, and they weren't really good cars, to be honest. This is a genuinely good car. It might not be the most powerful car in the world, but it's returning an average of 7.9 liters per 100 kilometers. And it's a 6-speed automatic. What's funny also is Kias kind of got their own design language. They didn't really, yes, the car's inspired by some other things out there, but you can't really tell. It just looks good. I mean, the Kia Stinger is a prime example. This car's got that Stinger type of stance in front, and oh, it looks damn good. Right, I'm switching to my camera, my phone's camera. If I put this car into reverse, look at that. The reverse view camera, with, if you turn the steering wheel, you even get guidelines. Look at that. So indeed, this car is packed to the brim. The bonging stuff with the sunroof is open. This car is packed to the brim with technology and features. And my first time in a Kia, my first time driving a Kia, if this is what they've come to in a small span of time, imagine 2 years from now. This is already a flipping good car. Even the seats feel and sit fantastic. Kia South Africa, thank you guys so much for sending me out this car and allowing me to show this car to my viewers. I'm sure they're gonna greatly appreciate it. There's a lot of them out there in the segment for this kind of car. Please test drive this vehicle before you buy another car for you. Just test drive it. I think a lot of you are going to be impressed, and a lot of you are going to be sold on the way this thing looks. Thank you so much for watching this video, everyone. Don't forget to hit that thumbs up button, subscribe, share with friends and family. Be free, be you, love a rebel.